Hey guys, it's Danny the Traveler, and I'm here with Rocky the Traveler. And we're over here in Great Yarmouth, which is a town in the east of England. And not sure why I picked this town. Actually, I'll tell you exactly why I picked this town. We're on our way up to Scotland, and I just really wanted to pick a place that has a beach. And yeah, it's really cheap. The bed and breakfasts are like £15 a night, and they're pet friendly. And but yeah, it's a bit of a ghost town, as you'll see. So we picked a bed and breakfast right by the beach and decided to explore. We had about 10 days to spend in this small town. So of course, we're gonna start by the beach. And Rocky does love rolling around in the sand. Our first couple of days here were pretty windy and gray, and it was like a post-zombie apocalyptic town. But it looks like today we picked a good day to film. It's a pretty sunny day today. Earlier this week it was actually raining a lot, and it was, you know, gray and it was cold. But today, as you can see, it's actually very nice. And so we're gonna go explore the seafront and its piers and the promenade. So let's check it out. On the way to the pier, we came across this cool little wind farm museum, though we didn't actually go inside. Now, the pier is actually one of the most impressive piers I've ever seen. In fact, there's more pier activities here than I've seen in most English beach towns, but there's just no people here to do any of them. I was told from May to about early September, it gets quite lively. We're here in the first pier, Britannia Pier. You see, there's a theater, some fun amusement park games, and even a little monster truck, which Rocky took a small ride in. So as you guys could see, there's tons of touristy stuff behind me, and there's even an American diner right here. But because it's low season, there's not that many people, so it's a bit of a ghost town. The food here seems pretty cheap, actually, looking at it. Wow, chicken burger, $3.50, that's cheap. Now, Yarmouth still had a lot of its old town charm, including some horse-drawn carriages, though we didn't get a chance to go on them. Despite the small number of tourists, we did see quite a few dogs, and there was even one pub slash restaurant which with Captain America, and that was quite pet friendly. They allowed dogs inside. The seafront has a lot of fun options, mostly family friendly stuff. And if you're not a fan of crowds, then you'll absolutely love it here in October. And it looks like there's a sea life ahead, which is, I think there's one in every town. It's a restaurant slash aquarium or something like that. So up ahead of us, we got the Wellington Pier, which is actually a bowling center. Let's check it out. This is Wellington Pier. When I first saw the second pier, I thought it was just a bowling alley, but we eventually circled around and saw that there was actually more to Wellington Pier than I thought. So behind me, you got the Pleasure Island amusement park, but as you can see, it looks quite empty. And the few days that we've been here, it's just seemed like a post-apocalyptic, abandoned, spooky amusement park. So, but it looks pretty cool. Next time, we'll explore Great Yarmouth during market day, where there's actually people. Thanks, guys. See you soon.